Welcome to Show and Tell with the Two Mortgage Guys. We come to you live on Facebook and YouTube every Tuesday at noon. Stick around.
Hey, everyone.
Hey.
You got Steve and I today. We thought it'd be nice to do a show on occasion where it's just two of us and we can kind of go through some subject matters that maybe we can't always talk about with a guest, but we're going to talk about student loans today. It's a hot topic right now. Got people wanting to know when they're going to get their government checks or their loans paid off. We're going to cover some of the upcoming changes in deferred payments if you've got student loans that are deferred. And then we're going to kind of wrap all this into how this impacts people that are maybe thinking about buying a home, getting pre-approved. So should be a pretty good show.
Yeah, it's good. And it's one of those topics, because Ryan, I've been in the business for years, that student loans are more relevant today than what they've been, 20 years ago. And then the way they're looked at or viewed, deferred, that kind of stuff on it is a whole different beast when you're looking to buy a house compared to if you're getting a car, right?
Oh, for sure. Yeah, and here's the thing. I feel like more and more people have student loans than, maybe 20 years ago, for sure, right? I feel like we see a lot of credit reports, and it's not cheap to go to college, and not everybody's getting free rides. So just something we see a lot, and we're going to kind of walk you through the impact. Is that Maddie that just said hi?
Yeah, she just popped on. Hey, so Yeah, there's certain things coming up. So this is a great time, right? I put this on the agenda to talk about this anyways, but we're going to show a slide here in a little bit. But coming up on October 1st, which is actually Saturday, is when everybody's sort of going to start to be eligible so you can do the application for the Biden initiative at that point. So it's perfect timing for us to be able to lay it out. So that's one of the things we're going to go through, some of the dates that you guys need to make notes of to help with it, because your student loans are coming due soon.
So Steve, they if you've got student loans, you have to physically go and apply for this? Are they just going to like take anybody's debt and write it off? Or is it something that each person has to go out and request?
Yeah, you've got to request it. And then there's timing for that too. I think it's a year that you have to request it, but the sooner the better. So you'll actually go, the link will be available October 1st, and then you can start it there. Experts are basically saying you probably should do it by at least the end of November, because it could take 4 to 6 weeks for that amount to be subtracted off your total student loan debt.
And if it's anything like tax returns, and like this year's been crazy on the delays for people getting back tax return money and then processing tax returns and all that. So
right.
And this is going to be another government endeavor, right? So, yeah, I'm thinking if you've got student loans, you probably want to get in there sooner than later, get the forms filled out, and get your share of relief, whatever that looks like. Which,
right.
I don't even know what it is, but, hey, money's money. I've been telling people, honestly, for probably the last 5 years, I've been telling anybody that I see that has student loans on their credit reports, if they're deferred, let them go. You know, if you have to make a payment, obviously make your payment. But we've been anticipating this. We've been saying this for a long time, that the next government relief wave is going to be student loan debt. And here we are. We're starting to see it now, where some of this stuff's going to be written off.
Right.
So
yeah, we'll get links down below on where you can search for this. But it's not something that they're just going to send out. But October 1st, I'm sure it'll be on CNN, NBC, and every place on where you go to click the button. So from what I researched on it, it's sort of like an application. You fill out your information, they're going to know it's yours, but they want to be able to tie you to that amount of student loans and verify your income, that you're below $120,000 if you're single, to qualify for that $10,000 elimination. Also, student loan, the end of that forgiveness period through COVID. So for the last 2 years, Ryan, nobody's had interest accruing on their student loans and nobody's made a payment on it. So what I've seen is people's lifestyles have changed a little bit, because that's not an expense they've been spending out. Now all of a sudden it's going to kick in and it's, hey, it's time to start paying this back.
And if you've got student loan debt, you need to be very aware of this, because this is going to be an easy mistake. I bet we're going to see millions of people. Oops, I totally forgot it was due now. And they're not making payments. And these things report to the credit bureau just like any other debt. And if you're late on a student loan payment and you have had otherwise great credit, and this is the first thing you've had show up, it will wreak some havoc on your score. Any type of derogatory, late payment, anything that shows up. And we see it all the time when we have really well qualified, or not, should I say qualified, high scored borrowers, really high score. And then they have one little thing hit their report, and man, they punish them for it. So be on the lookout for that. When these payments come due, is it the beginning of the year? It's January 1st, isn't it?
January 1st. So December's the last basically bonus month. So that's why these experts are saying get on early and get your application. And if it was me, I'd say do it that first week of October, because what you wanted to do is when your student loans come due in January, if that $10,000 is subtracted off your total balance you owe, your payment's going to be less than if that $10,000 is on there. So that way, you go into January, your payment's already at the lowest part you can. And there from Carrie's got the link. So good job, Carrie. It's just all these pieces. But Ryan, you said the same thing I was going to hit on is those late payments. This is it's going to happen, right? People are not going to do it right, and they're going to be late. Then that, and they're going to be trying to buy a house, and then it's going to affect their score. So put a note in your calendar for Christmas this year to get somebody to give you $250 for your student loan payment in January.
Yep, for sure.
You can get it
for sure. So let's kind of get into, you know, people watching might be, if they're watching us, we're on the radar for mortgages. Like, how does all this stuff impact your mortgage, right? Student loans. So you just said it, that for the last couple of years, your student loan payments have been deferred. But even though they're deferred, we still had to look at that debt and understand that at some point you're going to have payments again. So we still likely had to count some type of payment against you. And now that we're going to see these payments coming back, or some of them are still going to be deferred for various reasons, let's go through what that looks like with your average borrower and different mortgage types. So starting out with like conventional lending, if you're going to borrow money and you're putting, you know, 3 to 5% down or more, and you're going to do a conventional loan, you know, what are we looking at, Steve? What are we going to count if somebody's got $50,000 in debt, and even though it's deferred?
Right. So for conventional, for Fannie Mae, then it's 1% is what they're looking at of the total balance. Again, is why if it's 50,000, we're looking at in this example, if you get buy it, now it's only 40. So that's going to be the game changer there. So it's 1%. So easy math on that's $500 a month, but that's how much we have to count against that borrower for a debt.
And that's a big number. I mean, the way we figure out how much you can borrow for a mortgage is it's all kind of debt to income related. We look at your total gross monthly income. We compare it to your total debt. And there's a percentage that we can squeeze in there for a mortgage. So now all of a sudden, if you've got $50,000 of student loan debt, and we've got to count 1% of that. That's a big number. That's $500. That's could be a car payment or so. That's going to significantly impact how much you qualify for on a mortgage. So just be aware that even though it's deferred and you might not be making payments now, we still have to look at that.
Right. And honestly, and we know in the business that 1% is actually higher than what the actual payment's going to be.
Yeah.
But it's the guideline. So on the same concept for Freddie Mac, which is also conventional lending, which we do both Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. Not all lenders do that. So we have the ability to look at Freddie Mac. So if we have a borrower come in with a lot of student loan debt, we'll look at Freddie Mac because they only count 0.5%. So on that same scenario, like you said, now the payment's only $250. So that $250 can be the point between an approval and a denial on the loan, depending on your debt ratios.
Yeah, that's a big difference. And like you said, lots of places you can go get a mortgage. You can go to your bank, your credit union, the mortgage broker down the street, us. You got options. But not everybody is delivering loans to Freddie Mac or Fannie Mae or both. And it is a nice perk with us. We have the ability to do that in either location. So if we got somebody who's heavy on student loan debt, that's a big advantage.
Right.
And then what's government guidelines? So if you're looking at an FHA loan or if you're a veteran, well, before we get into VA, let's talk about like FHA, USDA.
Okay, so that they follow on them the same, like with Freddie Mac, the 0.5%. It used to be 1%, and it was sometime this past year they lowered it to 0.5%. So, yeah, so government lending's good on it with what you've got on that side, and then Freddie Mac if you have a lot of the student loan debt. And then on VA, you brought that up. So veterans, this is the only one that's still left around to where if your student loans are deferred for more than 12 months, then you don't have to count a payment against the veteran on it. So again, this is a VA thing. This is veterans. We're veteran friendly, but it's a great perk if you're a veteran that they use that on there if they are deferred. And if they're not and you're making your payments, that's what we're going to count against you in the regular debts.
Right. Yeah, big difference. So look, if you've got student loans, quick recap, go to the website when the links come out, you know, do what you need to do so that you can get your credit, you can get your discount, you can get your write-off, whatever you want to call it. Because first of the year, we're looking at payments kicking in, and that lower balance is obviously going to make a lower payment, and this means you're going to qualify for more home. And then there are guidelines to us having to count payments even right now. Even if you're not making them, just know that, you know, we still got to look at it. And my prediction is, as we move forward, we're going to see more of this. I think there'll be more relief. There's so much consumer student loan debt hanging out there. It's unbelievable. And I think you'll see a lot of that starting to get covered by government relief. And right. Then, hey, one other thing I didn't think about until just now, if you have student loan debt and you're in certain occupations, you go to work for schools or anything that's government employment, there's a lot of those guidelines where once you spend 10 years on that job, they write the whole thing off.
Right. So it's typically the public health side of it. If you're doing something like that, that they'll do it. And then that's some of that stuff you have to look at. But again, they'll do some of them are income-based repayment, income-driven repayment. There's different terminology in it, IDRs, IBRs. But that's basically where if you're, for example, making $50,000 a year at a certain job, if you stay in that job for a 10-year period, your student loans are forgiven 100%. We've got a couple clients in the past that their income-based repayment is zero. So for an example like that on conventional with Fannie Mae, if you pop up and say, hey, you've got $50,000 worth of student loan debt, but on your income-based repayment, it's zero. And we get something from the provider, the servicer verifying that, then we count zero. So that's a good perk on it as well. But that's Fannie's that way, not government. So, and then you have to have sometimes higher scores for Fannie than you need for FHA. So there's all kinds of pieces to it, but this is just one of those. And we see it, like Ryan said, on 70 or 80% of the credit reports we pull have student loans on them.
Hey, unless anyone has any other questions about student loans, if you do, just type in the comments down here. We're live, so we can answer them on the fly. But we do want to do a quick little market update too. Interest rates is another hot topic.
It is. Real quick, hey, I'm going to make sure Carrie throws that link she threw up in our comment section. So while we're on that, that's the link to get into it. So share this so people can get that link and be able to use it.
Yeah, absolutely. Now we can talk about rates. All right, so interest rates. Man, unless you've been living in a cave or under a rock, you've probably noticed these rates have continued to climb throughout the year.
Yeah.
They were crazy, crazy low. Look, first thing I need you to understand, if you're in your 20s and this is what you've known your life, right, is these low, low interest rates, then today's rates may seem crazy high. But if the reality is they're not, at some point in history, we've had much higher interest rates than we're at today. You can go ask your parents or grandparents about these stories of rates being at 18%. That happened. I think back to my first house. I'm 50. My first house, I was 21. I was at 8.5%. we're still underneath that. Okay. So these interest rates, although they're higher than they were a year ago, historically, we're still not like we're crazy high. Okay. We're still under the average interest rate. But in the last 8 months, we've seen these rates just continue to climb. And yesterday was the third biggest shift upwards in rates ever in one day. Okay. In one day movement. So there's just things that are happening right now in the economy, with the stock market, with the government and the Fed's attempt to curb inflation. There's all these things that are happening that are driving these mortgage rates higher. Well, we did get a little relief today from yesterday, like a little correction back. But all in all, uncertainty would be a very, very good word to use in the mortgage rate industry. We're watching them go up, and they may very well continue to climb even more.
You nailed it on. So it does that same thing. So it's just those little peaks, right? It's like climbing a mountain. It's not just this straight elevation. There'll be some days it's higher and then it dips back down, just maybe a little bit, not much.
Yeah.
Eighth of a point, if that, maybe quarter, but then it might go the other way and then it'll fill back a little bit. But that's been our story and it's going to continue. This isn't our first rodeo for Ryan and I doing this either. So we've been through this before. So that's where you can rely on us. We were back in before everything happened in 08 and even back in prior to that. So we've seen those rates. We've seen the market shift. We've seen it moved. We sort of need to know we can help coach you through this process that you're in on it.
We do subscribe to some different lock advisories. So we are given information on any given day, kind of given an idea of what to advise clients on, right? So whether or not they should be locking a rate. And right now the lock advisory is to lock. I mean, we're pretty much on everybody lock. But I will tell you this. Look, real estate is still a great investment. Don't let this defer you or detract you from buying a home. You should still be thinking about buying a home, especially if you're renting. Mortgages are not permanent. You know, you may borrow money today at today's interest rate, but when we do have a dip, and we will, it's just a matter of when, we can pay that mortgage off and replace it with a lower rate. You know, so it's that marry your home, date the rate. I've been hearing that all the time lately. So we do annual mortgage reviews with our clients. We have software programs that allow us to track their rates compared to market rate. If there's an opportunity in the future to save you money with a low rate, we're going to be contacting you. We're going to be all over that.
Right. And it's just the same thing. Like Ryan said before, his was higher. Mine was 10.75 when I got my first one. And Ryan was just said over the weekend, who was your parents or something talking about that where they were at rate wise.
Yeah.
When I got into the business, it was 8.75 was the 30-year rate. And my interest rate was 8.25 on my mortgage. I thought I was in great shape. That went from 10.75. So I kept refinancing multiple times to get it down.
Yep.
Where it needs to be at on it. So
and that's probably what's going to happen here in the upcoming years. We'll peak out at some point and God willing, we get a little bit of a dip and we'll get people in the lower rate. So,
right.
Well, anything else we need to talk about, Steve?
No, I think that covered most of the stuff on it. We just really want to get that information out to you guys. One on student loan relief, sort of the options on how to do it, timing on it. Just remember, try to do that first week of October. Get it rolling with you as quick as you can. And really, we've seen it time and time again. Just make that first payment January. Don't be late. Get that on the schedule. Have it automatically pulled out of your checking or savings. You got to get that going with what you've got on it. And then give us a call and we'll help you through the rest of the process with it. So that's good. Yeah. So before we say goodbye, you guys have anything that you want to bring back up, please put it in the comments down below. Share this video. If you have any of those questions on the student loan stuff, we did a bunch of research, so we'll be glad to answer it for you. Thanks.
Next week, we're going to be featuring our second community spotlight. We're going to interview Kevin Smith. He's the new executive director of the Kokomo Rescue Mission. He's going to be sharing about the month-long food drive beginning Saturday and all the great things the mission is doing in our community. Be sure to tune in next Tuesday at noon.